Betsy's got it. Thank you, Betsy. Okay, so I usually follow the same process every single time. Can you just set it down back there for me? Thank y'all. So I follow the same process every time, so I don't forget one of these things. There's a couple things you definitely don't want to forget. We'll get to it. But I always start with the feet, so we're going to take the feet off first. So nice sharp knife. This is going to get dull. There's no way around it. But it always gets dull whenever you hit bone. So what you're looking for is the spaces between the bones. So basically what you have here is you have a knee. So what we're going to be doing is just making a quick slice and holding the bird this way. So the breast is up. That will get you at the top part of the knee and make a quick slice as best you can tell between those two joints. Okay. In the same spot, sweetie.
Yep.
Okay. And so what you're trying to do is just get between those. You make a couple cuts and then it comes right through. Okay. How'd you do?
Good. She did awesome.
She's gonna show me up. So real quick about feet, you can save the feet. The feet are fantastic. They've got an excellent source of collagen. We are not saving feet right now because most people don't buy feet. But if you're gonna save some for yourself, we always save a handful for ourselves. If you guys want to save your feet today, we'll figure it out. But for now, we're not going to. So we're going to take the second one off, same exact process, a couple slices, and you're done. By the way, we've done this a few times, so if you can't do that, it's okay. All right, so I'm going to rinse.
Okay. What are we doing? Sorry, guys. Things get wet.
It's slimy.
Is it because of the feathers are flying? Or we just always try to rinse.
What was the question?
For kind of... Why rinsing
so much? Oh yeah, just cleanliness to keep guts and stuff out of
and kind of keep this wet too so it doesn't dry.
Yeah. Okay, so next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and take the head off. So Austin's done a pretty good job of that. So again, you don't wanna cut too much of the bone because it's gonna dull your knife faster. So we just get down to the neck. she is gonna show me up. She's already taken the head off. All right, it comes off. Stop us, guys, if you have questions. And you guys are going to be doing, you guys are going to do every single one of these. So you guys are going to, this is all stuff you guys are going to do. You already cut that.
No, I'm waiting.
Okay, I'm a bigger person. So now what we've got is we've got a lot of extra skin here on the neck. Now, note about this skin. When you guys go to bag these, it's very important because you're going to be cutting the neck off. When you cut the neck off, you're going to get some sharp pieces that will poke through your bag. So it's very important that you keep as much of the neck skin as you can. However, we need to be able to get to a couple of tubes here. You'll see that in a second. So I usually take about 1 to 2 inches of the skin itself. And I want to take that off. I'm done.
I didn't take my neck. I already got my tubes.
Oh, come on. Okay. So now what you're going to have on this on these chickens is you're going to have two tubes that go down into the cavity. So you have your esophagus and your windpipe. So where all the food goes and where the air goes. You want both of these basically are going to pull away from the neck. And you're going to want to slide those. Don't pull hard, but slide them up against the breast. So kind of separate those out because these we want to keep separate. Now, we've had these chickens off of feed for 24 hours. That's not always possible. If you got them on pasture especially, there's nothing in the crop I can tell. But if there's something in the crop, this is very important because you don't want to have that stuff pouring out into the meat because this is breast meat right here. So we slide these over to the back. Next thing we're going to do.
Sorry. I broke one of my tubes.
Oh, okay. Good thing. So you wanted to separate and have your own.
No,
I'm just making sure.
I'm going.
No, we don't. We're not competitive about it.
I'm trying to stay up with you.
Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is there is, if you think about this, it's going to sound kind of gross, but think about how all the tubes that you've got in your neck, they go down into the chest. So basically, if you were able to cut your neck open and slide a finger down there, you could puncture down in through into where your heart and your lungs and everything else are. And that's exactly what I'm going to do. So I'm just going to take my index finger and I'm going to slide that down in there. And what I'm trying to do is separate some of the kind of bits and pieces that hold on to everything here. And I kind of work my way around the neck. want to make sure that they're, you give plenty of space for these tubes to basically slide back the other direction, because that's how they're headed. How are you doing, sweetie?
Think okay.
Yeah. Okay?
I've got it all. It feels like it's all separated from the neck.
So you're just breaking up all that connective tissue there. Yeah.
Correct.
Yeah, so
yeah.
Be careful so that on your skin. Make sure you keep some of that skin on there.
Yeah, I got all
that. Lori's our, she is our quality control. So she makes sure that the end process is done completely. Mm-hmm. But she's done this a few times herself. There's a question.
So when you do it, you go like down and then kind of like pry away from the neck?
You kind of work your finger around the neck bone.
Okay, so yep. Just kind of like making like an air pocket, kind of just all the way around.
Break up anything, yeah. Anything that's connected to it, break that away.
And your hand will just slide. At first, it kind of pushes against, and then your hand will just slide into the chest cavity.
Okay.
Yeah, so I'm pushing kind of down on the neck this way. So, yeah. Okay. All right, so next step, what you're going to do is we need to open up the back end here. So, what you're looking for is you want to be, the vent is right here, and you have your breastbone, the top of your breastbone is right here. So what we're doing is about the halfway point between those two, we're going to make a very small incision, easier to grab the skin, pull it up. You want to be very careful not to cut too deep here, because there are intestines right below that. So very important that you're not making a deep cut. You want to basically get through the skin. Good there, sweetie?
Yeah.
Okay. And so then what you're going to do is, hard, going to be hard to see, but you're going to take your fingers and basically just push them into that space. So I use my middle finger, my index finger, and then what you're going to do is just pull gently, because it won't take a lot, and don't pull too hard, especially if you guys are going to want to sell these, because it's going to start ripping things that people aren't used to seeing. But you want to be big enough so that your hand can get in there. So now for you big guys out there, you guys whoop me when it comes to lifting weights, but when it comes to a chicken and these little skinny fingers, it's a lot better. So now what we're going to do is we're going to take, it's hard to describe this because we'd be coming from the tail end, but basically what we're doing is we're going to take our hand and we're going to work ourselves, I need to rinse. Usually we're done at this point, so get a little dry. Okay, so what we're trying to do is we're going to take our hand and work it basically up against the chest cavity. And you're not going to hurt anything as long as you keep your hand like this. And you're just going to kind of work your way around. If you guys have had a whole chicken before, this is where the stuff that comes with your chicken is located, okay? So like the neck that they give you, if they give you gizzard or heart, stuff like that, liver, they're in here. So what we're doing is we're trying to separate this ball of guts that are in there. There's a bunch of different connective material that's inside here, and you're trying to get all the guts into like a ball, because we're going to be pulling them out here in just a second. So work your way around up towards the neck, but don't puncture anything, because we got tubes we got to pull
out. Are we pulling it onto the table so they can see what's in there?
Yeah. So now there's one of the things about this, making sure you don't cut open any of the guts. We're going to pull these out here in a second. We will pull the guts out onto the table. Another reason why we keep them clean all the time, it's just easier. So now what we're gonna do is you wanna get a hang, hold on to, Lori, did you grab the heart? I like to pull the heart out first.
Oh, I just pull everything out.
Okay, so the biggest thing here,
here's the heart.
The only thing that's gonna get hurt, that's gonna hurt the whole process, is gonna be the gallbladder. So the gallbladder is full of bile, and bile will mess up your chicken. So you don't want to puncture that. So Lori's already at me again.
Sorry.
So that's, you can see everything's right coming out in a pile. Okay. Now there's still a connection here. That's your esophagus and your windpipe. Okay.
On the back
side
of the liver.
If you don't get the esophagus and the windpipe out of these birds, it doesn't.
That fussy green.
If there's something in the crop, you need to be very careful, because you got feed or grass or whatever else might be in that crop. There's nothing in ours. So if you wind up pulling and you break things, don't worry about it. But what I want to show you is in this pile of guts is your gallbladder. Sweetie, you want to show them that?
Yeah.
So that's your gallbladder right there.
Oh, wait. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. So it's the only thing in there that's going to be dark like that. So it's attached to your liver. It's what helps you digest fats. I won't get into too much anatomy. But the bile is the key. It's green, like a bright green. So if you break it, a very, very bright green liquid's going to come out. So you know you hit the gallbladder. That is a fire sale if you see that. You need to get everything out of there as quickly as possible and rinse that cavity out as fast as possible. Bile looks extremely bitter. Very, very bitter. Like, more bitter than you can imagine. So getting that on a piece of the meat you're wanting to eat is not a good thing. So that, you want to get out and away from the whole process as fast as you can. So now inside we've got, we're still stuck. I can't pull the rest of this out. That is actually your esophagus that goes down into your gizzard. We talked about that. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and start to pull on this. Now I get both hands in there. I slowly pull on this guy here. And if I do this right, I'll get the windpipe.
I already got mine out, sorry.
Oh, you just...
I know.
Okay, sorry. So...
Thank you.
I broke this. This is your windpipe here.
So it's the pipes that were up here that we pulled, the tubes up here. So you pull those actually through.
So this is your crop right here. So that's normally in the side of the neck up here. So you can see we pulled that out clean. That's where the food initially goes and then goes down into the gizzard. Okay. So now what we're dealing with is we're dealing with the business end of a chicken. So there's not much in here. These guys haven't been eating for a day, but there's still going to be some. Now, if poop gets in there, it doesn't really matter. You just rinse that out, okay? But if you can keep it from happening, you want to. What you're going to want to do is make a cut on either side of this. I'm just going to call it a butthole, you guys. And you got a rectum down there, too. So what we do, we'll be there when you guys are doing this together, but the rectum is right up against this tail right here. And what we're trying to do is get rid of that butthole right there. You don't want that on your chicken. You get somebody that you sell one of these to, and they've got a butthole, and they're going to wonder what's going on. Okay, so as far as parts and pieces, by the way, that's, we got more to do there, but I want to show you guys a few things here. If you guys are wanting to save your livers, the important thing with this right now is separating your gallbladder from the liver, because it is attached. So the easiest thing to do is to pinch right up against the liver, the gallbladder, and then basically just pull the liver apart that way. Okay, you can see it actually looks, that's pretty good. That's about as good as it gets for taking a chicken. The gallbladder, you can see, is actually still sealed. There's no green. The next thing out of this pile that you might want to save would be your gizzard. This is a very, very small gizzard. Sometimes they're always a little bit different. So we'll separate that out as well. So as far as your parts and pieces that you guys are probably used to seeing when you get a chicken, is your heart, your gizzard, and your liver. And Lori's got... that liver looks pretty good, too.
Science class.
So now if your liver looks like a mangled mess, it's okay. That happens all the time. That's just because you're reaching in there and you're trying to grab that stuff up. So chances are really good that you guys won't get much of a liver today. But if you want to save parts and pieces, this would be it. The only thing that needs to be processed further is your gizzard. So you do need to get the stuff out of the gizzard. There will be green in here. It is...
You cutting it open?
You got it. Yep. So you can see there's not much in there because they were off feed for so long. But that is a bull pebble. There's another one. Actually, you know what? Those are...
Oh my gosh.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Pasture raised.
Yep. So you can see this one's got a little bit of grass that he ate yesterday. Now there's a second part to a gizzard. So you have this piece here. This is very, very tough. And so you can actually separate this from the gizzard itself.
So like a lining.
Which is how you guys always see it. This is easier, by the way, with bare hands as opposed to gloves. We have gloves for all you guys today, though. So, so you want to get this skin off of your gizzard. That's not what you want to eat. How are you doing there, sweetie?
I'm getting it. Right. It's hard with these gloves.
The gloves make
it on my hand.
Is it hard to get the smell off your bare hands if you don't wear gloves?
All right. That's how you're used to seeing it. Okay? How you doing, sweets? You got it?
Got it.
Okay, good. All right. So those are your parts and pieces. We've got baggies for you guys today. If you want to try to save those, you guys are welcome to. If not, don't worry about it. Coyotes will be very thankful if you leave them here today. I'm not going to save these today. So do we have a bowl?
I have two big bowls somewhere. I thought I had them out
here. Okay, we'll just need a little bit of ice. Okay, so next thing. Inside the cavity, we said there was two tubes that we took outside, or that we had to take through the neck in through here. One of them was the esophagus. We were just dealing with that business here. The other one is your windpipe. So that goes down to your lungs, which are still inside the cavity. They are down here in two pockets down on the bottom of this. I'll show you guys when you guys are doing your own chickens, but you're going to slide your finger in there and the lungs will come out.
Towards the back.
So on
it's towards the back.
Yeah, and then on the bottom, you'll feel like the ribs. If you get your fingers and just kind of slide them along the ribs, and then that'll pull up your lungs.
Need to get a microphone for you, too. You explained that perfectly beautiful.
Sorry. But I like choirs.
I don't like choirs.
They won't rupture.
So, lungs, by the way, are kind of, they're kind of creepy. They float in water. So they don't cook all that well. So people generally don't eat the lungs, but, animals love them. Right. Lungs. Thank you, Tara. All right. You good, sweets?
Yeah, I don't think I got all the lungs.
All right. Rinse. Watch yourselves, guys. Especially Lori's, her water might be a little bit stronger.
Can I get rid of all this stuff now?
Yeah. Here, I've got a bucket, or I've got a bowl for the inside.
Okay. Lori's got one, too.
Okay.
Your bowl will be there.
Mommy. What's that?
Okay. Okay. Right here? That's nice and clean inside of there. That's what you guys used to see if you guys get a hold of it. All right, so next thing we're going to do. This is usually where my quality control person comes in. It's removing this little oil gland. So on the back of your chickens, there's an oil gland. If you guys ever watch chickens, they like to mess with their back, and then they come back up, and they're kind of doing this thing. Ducks do the same. What they're doing is they're waterproofing their feathers. And what they do is they use this oil out of this gland back here. Now, you don't want this on your chicken. It's nasty because it's this bitter oil. So what you're going to want to do is make a cut above. The gland is down here at the bottom. Make a cut above. Grab it with your finger and just slice kind of along the tailbone there. And what you're looking for is no yellow. So if you see there, there's no yellow on there. It's a bright yellow if you get the oil on there. Okay. But the oil is inside here. Sometimes the oil will come out. It's not a big deal if you get a little bit of oil on the chicken. The gallbladder is the only one where it's really bad. All right. Back over. Now we're going to go back up to the neck. Good. So inside the neck, you have a lot of different little glands here. So what we're going to do is we're going to take some of these out of there. That's just not attractive. And not that it's going to be bad. It doesn't really matter because it's up here in the rest of the neck stuff. But we take these off just because, well, it's right. These are just like lymph glands and things like that. All right. You good?
Sure.
Okay. So now I start from the back. Doesn't matter where you guys do, but you want to pull the neck skin back as far as you can. And we're going to be dealing with the neck now because we need to get the neck off. So this is where your knife winds up getting dull no matter which way you do it. But you want to get down as far as you can along the back. Make an incision here. Be careful because you're cutting into wings over here. And I'm going to flip it, and I need to get down into this pocket here. And you know you're cutting next to your breast meat, which is right here. So you don't want to be slicing that up either. So you got to be very careful. This is where you slice and dice yourself. Just want to make a couple of incisions on the neck. I know when you're gonna.
Good.
Just take the bird, spin it, and that comes off. Okay. And that's basically it. Okay, so the only other things that we're going to do here is Usually I'll probably just give this to Lori because she is our quality control. I will simply miss tail feathers. I'll miss feathers. There's no way around it. So the neck, we always put the neck in. So whenever we sell a chicken, the neck is included so people can make stock. We generally don't include the liver, the gizzards, or the heart because we have a few customers that like those. And so we keep those separate. Plus, it's easy to get those lost and they can get kind of nasty. So we'll just rinse real good.
So you're gonna go over like 10 feathers or anything? Or?
So, well, as far as how to remove them?
Or you just can't do that as they're on the
table? I don't do pin feathers.
I do pin feathers. I go through and any like of the little pin feathers that are left on here, I pull off.
Hold on.
Well, why don't you tell them?
No, you tell them.
I go through any of the pin feathers that are left, I pull them off, and that's what I have the little pliers for. So they're much easier to use. Instead of trying to do it with your hands.
There we go. I need to be right there. You're doing a great job.
Half the time I have to check to make sure he got all the lungs.
Okay, now I knew that was waiting. That was coming. There's no way around that. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and put the neck inside the cavity. Am I good, honey?
Yeah, I still have lungs in my neck. Go ahead.
All right, so I'm gonna just let you kind of finish this up so we can get everybody wrapped up. Okay,
that's good.
You guys are gonna have questions. That's okay. We just wanted you guys to see the whole process before you guys literally got your hands dirty. So we're gonna do that. Now, what I need to know first is, and that's it, by the way. Oh, one other thing. So Tara's sitting on our cooler. I'm gonna wait until I want Lori to QC this one for me. But that has ice water in there and it also has salt. So not a lot, we're not trying to brine the chickens. It has about half a cup of salt. Those are 120 quart, 125 quart coolers. About half a cup of salt. That's pretty much half full of water, so it's extremely diluted. But it does help pull the blood out of the chicken. So obviously we drained a lot of that over there. There's still some blood in there. So, and you want to start cooling this chicken down now, all right? So this would normally go right into there, but I'm gonna give Lori this one to finish. He doesn't believe in gloves.
This is the point you'll tag your chicken to.
Oh, yes.